Next on Road to the White House, earlier today, Democratic vice presidential candidate Joe Biden and Congressman John Murtha spoke at a rally in Johnstown, Pennsylvania, where they attempted to blow the election for Senator Obama.
How's everybody doing today? Now, before we get started, I want to clear the air about something I said last week when I suggested the good people here in Western Pennsylvania are racist. That's not at all what I meant to say. It's more that they're ignorant. They don't know any better, especially your older ones. They're just bone ignorant. It's like someone said earlier in the campaign, I don't remember who. They cling to guns and religion because they feel threatened. And that's so true.
All right, Jack.
I couldn't say it any better myself, but enough from me. I'm going to hand this over to a guy you all know, the next Vice President of the United States, Joe Biden.
Thanks, Jack. Thank you, Jack. Thank you very much. Congressman Jack Murtha, everybody. That's all right. Let me tell you something, Johnstown. 2 weeks from now, with the help of the good people of Western Pennsylvania, we're going to elect a new president, President Barack Obama. That's right. Hey, look at that. I see we got Pete Harrigan here today. Look at that, a great state senator. Give it up for Pete. Stand up, Pete. All right, Pete. Let me tell you something else, and listen to me well. As sure as I'm standing here today, during his first few weeks in office, this brilliant young president is going to be tested. Tested by an international crisis, the likes of which this nation has never before seen. A deliberately manufactured crisis designed to test his mettle. That's right. Now, in this crisis, he will have to make decisions. Decisions that, at first, while they may seem, to the casual observer, seem a little ill-considered. Our military may invade Pakistan or surrender to the Chinese. We may sell Hawaii to Saudi Arabia or just destroy it so it can't fall into North Korean hands. But just reserve your judgment. We know what we're doing. That's right. Hey, Mickey Doyle. County Treasurer, everybody, Mickey Doyle. Nice to see you, Mickey.
If I could say something here, earlier what I said about Western Pennsylvania being ignorant, I was misquoted.
All right.
I meant more backward. Your people out here just don't understand the modern world because they're uneducated. They don't have radios or that kind of thing. Also, they're racist. Ooh.
Mark my words, if you take away nothing else from what I say here today, or indeed in this entire campaign, remember this. If Barack Obama is elected, we will have a crisis. And when this crisis hits, and it will, in the second week of February, we may do some weird things. We may cede Florida back to Spain, or Alaska to the Russians. We may blow up every nuclear power plant in the country. We may set fire to Washington, D.C. We may round up all French Canadians. But don't lose faith. It's all part of a plan. Hey, look, there's Pat Reardon, everybody. A great assistant DA here in Greene County. Pat Reardon, good to see you, Pat. Hey, how you doing?
If I could.
Oh, boy.
I want to say one more thing about the people of Western Pennsylvania. Has anyone here ever seen a movie called Deliverance?
Come on, Matt.
No? Never mind, then.
Okay, all right. I'm going to say something else now, and I want you to mark well the words that I say. Well, the words that I say, and remember that I said them here today. In the second year of the presidency of Barack Obama, a young child shall come from out of the north, from a city of steel. And this child shall rule for a time, but the child shall rule falsely. in deceit. By the trident of Neptune, what I have spoken is the truth.
Joe, do you think this child could be one of them Palin kids?
All right, be silent. Come on. Come on. Mark well, as I stand here today, this time of trouble shall last 1 year, 1 month, 1 day, 1 hour, and 1 minute. Hey, Phil. Hey, how you doing, Phil? It's Phil Malloy, head of the local worker steel. There he goes. How you doing, Phil? But at the appointed hour, the time of trouble shall end, and peace shall come to this land for over 100 years. The mouse shall bell the cat. The lamb shall lead the lion. The poor and ignorant shall know wisdom and plenty.
You hear that, Western Pennsylvania? That'll be your time. What happens after the 100 years?
Beware the man with one sandal. He is not of woman born. That is all I can reveal. The rest is classified.
Fair enough. You got that, people? Keep an eye out for a guy with one sandal who's maybe a robot or a test tube baby or some kind of deal like that. But if you spot him, don't, you know, try to handle it yourself.
Right.
Call the proper authorities.
That's right. Gird your loins! By the beard of Jupiter, gird your loins!
I think my loins are okay. I was just at the doctor.
Good, good. As it has been spoken, so it shall come to pass. Hey, Andy Brennan's here. Look at that, Andy Brennan. You know Andy, right?
We will now leave this event and go to an Obama-Biden rally in Kansas City, Missouri, where former President Clinton is about to spend 2 hours recounting the achievements of his administration before he forgets to mention the Democratic candidate.
And one more thing. Live from New York, it's Saturday night!